Hello guys, so I'm here at the sign, 1.9 miles from the junction to get to Mount Whitney. It was pretty sunny and then suddenly it's all dark and a little bit cold. You can feel the elevation a little bit more once you go up. So we're almost there. Looks like this part has way less snow than the other side, which is nice. It's a little bit more drier here. Just some patches, but nothing serious. Some people going up over there, so we gotta go all the way up, all between rocks. The trail is well marked so far, as you can see. It's a nice pass of the trail. You see all the rocks. So far the climbing is not too bad, but the altitude is the most that drains you out a little bit, but it's pretty fun. It's a nice part of the trail, you go between these rocks. That looks like a window over there. Kind of cool. Hiking on rocks. So we gotta go all the way up to over there. Views. Let's just check it my GPS and it says I'm 1 mile away. So we got another mile. Another 0.9 to the top to make sure that that sign is correct. Yeah, almost there, guys. Almost there. I have my fleece jacket, but I might end up wearing my down jacket and my beanie once I'm up there. Let's see how it goes. And after this trip, guys, I have a Ray Lake trip that I'm doing in 3 days. Next week you can also watch it up in my YouTube channel. And guys, I almost made it to the top, to the sign. There is a shelter over there. There is a few people too. You know, they woke up super early to hiking. I'm almost there, guys. I'm almost there, guys. Super close to the sign. My breathing is good now. I mean, it's just kind of get time to get used to it, but after you can keep hiking, it gets better. As you see, there are 2 people over there, 3 people maybe. People who wake up very early to hike from trail camp. And the views are breathtaking here. That sign, I think, is behind that shelter, and there is a book where you can sign your name and the date that you arrive to the summit, which is kind of cool. So this is a shelter, guys. Let's see what's in there. So here, if you see, it says erected 1909. And here's the paper. Is a paper where you sign your name on the date, the time you arrive here, which is kind of cool, a lot of stickers. You can see stickers from different places. And this is how it looks inside the shelter, which is always open. It's full of snow. I'm not sure why it's full of snow, but it's kind of cold here because of the snow on the walls. Kind of sucks. People, they graffiti the rocks. It's another warning for extreme danger from lightning. So this is the shelter. Not the sweat through. The sign. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, Dan, guys.
Good. How are you?
Good.
Nice.
It was fun. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. Congrats too.
Thank you.
And there is the behind the shelter. Looks like they have some decoration before here, but it's broke down. And because of the season and winter, it's just destroyed all. More true hikers coming. It was windy, now it's very sunny. No wind, no windy anymore, which is pretty nice. Kind of enjoy the view here. Hello. And there is the sign over there. Let's go around. Beautiful weather. There is another sign over there on the rock. National Park Service, US Department of Interior. Sorry about that. That is the sign. Sun is snug now in the summit. More people coming up. And it is 1.9 miles from the junction where the sign was. It's just that it feels longer because of the altitude. It makes you kind of slow down. It's like driving a four-cylinder car going uphill. Nice place to hang out. There's the sign over there. Hello, guys. And the coin. I think somebody bring this small sign. I didn't see this before.
That sign's new?
Yeah. Last time I came last year, it was only this big sign. And this is a new one too, because they have an older one before. This one, maybe somebody made it.
Yeah.
Kind of nice, they bring it.
That's like a big one.
Yeah, it's beautiful. And this is a view. Just gotta be careful when I'm recording. at this, guys. There is the ice lake over there. Looks blue too. Most lakes are ice from this view. Here is another point. And another one here. Now I'm leaving, guys. It was a nice hike up here. A little bit before leaving. It's just roads. It's cold now. It was sunny, then it got cloudy and it's windy. Now it's gonna be a little bit easier to come down. I'm gonna wear my glove. It's cold. See you later, or see you soon, Whitney. I know it's gonna be the last time I come here again. I've been here a few times already. Pick up my stuff and meet with my friends. Beautiful view. I have to hike all the way down to that lake. That's where my friends are. So I gotta go all from here. It's gonna be fun because now I'm gonna be facing down. So it's not an easy task to do. Walk on the hike on the snow. Okay, guys. Coming down that way. It's a way different feeling when coming up. How cold was last night? Somebody dropped their water and it's completely ice. A little bit water, but mostly ice. And the pole that was stuck over there, I tried to take it out. Couldn't do it. It was stuck in a rock of ice. Hello, buddy.
It's all pheasant.
Oh, he's so cool.
He's cute, huh?
He's right now I'm coming down and our goal is to get to Whitney Portal today. Still we have a good time, so it's gonna be okay. And my friend Jose Bighorn, he went to the Lone Pine Lake just to do some exploring. And right now I'm going there too. So this is a trail, it's like maybe 5 minutes hike down from the junction. It's worth the hike, it's just 5 minutes and you get a view of this amazing lake. One of the few lakes that are no ice, because you keep going up after Mirror Lake, all the lakes are ice and you can still get some summer heat here, even if it's not summer yet. To the lake, and there's a friend I made in the trail. Hello, from LA, from my hood. was up, Salon? I can see the parking lot from here. I'm almost there. The end of the trip. It's not going back to the car, but it is going back home safe with the loved ones. Thanks God, the safe trip. Now I can see the Porto from here. That's really nice. I'm glad everything came good as expected. Here it is. With the Porto. Let's see if the cafe is open. And remember, guys, that you need one of these to get one of these. If you don't have one, you can always use one from here, but if you didn't use it, please put it back. Now let's go check it out, the cafe. Looks like the cafe is over there. Let's see if it's open. It's kind of amazing to take a picture with the sign right here and then all the way on the top. Let's check it out if the coffee shop is open. Looks like it's open, which is nice. They have huge dishes right here. They're pretty huge hamburgers and breakfast. It's nice that they are back to business. Let's check it out. Have a cold beer too. Let's see what time they open and close. Doesn't say. So here is the store. They have souvenirs and food, I think. Let's see. So here is the other side of the coffee shop. This is the way to get in. I was coming in from the wrong way. So here it says it's open from 8 to 8 every day, but the kitchen closes at 7. And here is the menu. Okay. Just to give you an idea, they have breakfast, lunch and dinner, hamburger, hot dogs, pancakes. Food is really good here. Max is required, and this is the souvenir shop. They have all kind of gear, like if somebody needs any gear before starting a hike or backpacking trip. And they have all kind of gear here, more. And ice cream, and they have beer too, I'm pretty sure. Let's go this way. Just give you a... Here is the refrigerators for the sodas, the juice, and this is the special one, the drinks. So let's see what we're gonna get. I think I'm gonna get a Sierra Nevada, that one, and a cheeseburger. Now having a hamburger from the Lone Pine Cafe. Now having a hamburger with a Sierra Nevada beer here at the cafe. And we need Porto. Bon appetit.